Hello everyone, I am Dr. Sirajul Akfaizi. I welcome you in my YouTube channel. Today in this video, we are going to learn about identification of plant pigment. You know plant pigment, one is carotenoids by thin layer chromatography. So this is the chemistry laboratory task and especially organic chemistry. So in this video, I will focus on the theory of thin layer chromatography and how you identify this plant pigment through TLC. So I will give the brief introductions about the plant pigment and then I will show you how thin layer chromatography help in the identifications of these carotenoids. So let us start. Brief introductions. You know friends, carotenoids are a class of natural fat soluble pigment found principally in plants, algae and photosynthetic bacteria, where they play critical role in photosynthetic process. They also occur in some non-photosynthetic bacteria, yeast and molds, where they may carry out protective functions against damage by light and oxygen. You know friend, although animals appear to be incapable of synthesizing carotenoids, many animals incorporate carotenoids from their diet within animals, and carotenoids serve as antioxidants and can be source for vitamin A activity. You know, this is the reference. If you want to read more and more, go through this reference. So in this picture you can see the carotenoid rich substances. Now friends, you also know carotenoids are responsible for many of the red, orange and yellow color of plant leaves, fruits and flowers, as well as colors of some birds, insects, fish, crustacean. Some familiar example of carotenoids colorations are oranges of carrots and citrus fruit, the reds of peppers and tomatoes, and pinks of flamingos and salmon. And some 600 different carotenoids are known to occur naturally, and new carotenoids continue to be identified. These are the references. Now you can see the beta carotenoid structure. This is the beta carotenoid structure. This compound is only carbon and hydrogen compounds. So friends, the aim of this experiment is, in this experiment you will extract plant pigment and then identify these pigments by chromatography. So what material you need? You need petroleum ether, you need acetone, you need 10% sodium chloride, you need calcium carbonate, you need anhydrous sodium sulfate, you need fresh leaves, you need TLC chamber 22 into 22 into 10, you need TLC silica gel plate, you need mortar and pestle, you need separating funnel 100 milliliter, you need measuring cylinder 100 milliliter, you need 5 measuring cylinder 25 milliliter, you need aluminum flask 100 milliliter, and round bottom flask 100 milliliters. Now friend, what is the procedures? So I will discuss, I will light on one by one and step by step. You need developing solvent first, mobile phase, 10 milliliter of petroleum ether, 10 milliliter of acetone and 5 drop of distilled water. Then you make the developing solvent. Now the second step, preparing of the TLC chamber. The developing solvent is placed into a TLC chamber, thin layer of chromatography chamber. The solvent should completely cover the bottom of the chamber to a depth of the approximately 0.5 cm. The chamber is closed and shaken. It is kept covered so that evaporation doesn't change the composition of the developing solvent mixture. After 50 minutes, the chamber will be saturated with the solvent. Now friend, extraction of the leaf pigments. In first step, you need to do using a pestle, fresh leaves are grinded in the mortar containing 25 milliliter of acetone, 3 milliliter of petrol ether and a spatula tip full of calcium carbonate. You can see in this picture. Then the pigment extraction is filtered. See in this picture. Then the filtrate is put into a separating funnel and is mixed with 20 milliliter of petrol, ether and 20 milliliter of 10% aqueous sodium chloride solution, and then the separating funnel is shaken carefully. You can see when the layer have separated, the lower layer is allowed to drain into a beaker and this phase is thrown away. Then you can see the upper layer is washed 3 to 4 times with 5 milliliter of DW, means deionized water. And then you can see in this picture, afterward the extract is placed in a Erlenmeyer flask and is dried with about 4 spatula tips of sodium sulfate and filtered and evaporate the solvent on water bath until the final volume become of about 3 ml. Now friends, application of the extract to the TLC plates. With a pencil, a line is drawn approximately 1.5 cm from the bottom of the plate. The procedure is repeated until the line is very dark green. The transfer extract is allowed to dry thoroughly after each addition. The line is kept as thin and straight as possible. Do the experiments procedure like that. The loaded TLC plate is carefully placed in the TLC chamber with the sample line toward the bottom. The plate whose top is leaned against the jar wall should sit on the bottom of the chamber and be in the contact with the developing solvent. Solvent surface must be below the extract line. The TLC chamber is covered. The TLC plate is allowed to remain undisturbed. When the solvent front has reached 3/4 of the length of the plate is removed from the developing chamber and then position of the solvent front is immediately marked. Now from results and discussions. As the solvent, you know, the rises by capillary action up through the TLC plate. The component of pigment mixture are partitions between the mobile phase solvent and stationary phase silica gel due to their different absorption and solubility strength. The more strongly a given component is absorbed to the stationary phase, the less easily it's removed by mobile phase. The more weakly a component is adsorbed, the faster it will migrate up the TLC plate. On the other hand, the running distance depends on the solubility of the pigment in the solvent. Since the experiment implies a high nonpolar solvent, you know, friend, petroleum ether, the pigments that are least polar, keratins, will be best solved in the nonpolar solvent and will thus have the largest running distance. Now you can see here, this is your inside, this is the glass jar, inside there is a TLC chamber, and then you can see with the stationary phase and mobile phase. Now you can see here carotenes and pheophyne, chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B, lutein, alloxanthine, noxanthine. So there are a lot of, now you can see. So RF value, beta carotenes, leaf pigment, color golden, RF value, this, pheophytine, olive green, RF value 65.65, chlorophyll A, blue green, 0.45, chlorophyll B, yellow green, lutein, yellow, viloxanthine, yellow, neoxanthine, yellow, 0.71, xanthophyll, yellow brown. So my friends, I hope this video will be helpful to you. If you like this video, then subscribe my channel and thanks for watching.